Sorry, I accidentally pressed the button over there and I wasn't even ready. You'll have to forgive me if this came in a little bit earlier than expected. Just prepare. Let me just breathe in. This is the first time I'm pitching my project to anyone because I was actually thinking of keeping it close to the rest of the world until, well, I mean, like, my friend there really convinced me to do so. The concept behind my project, or the project that we're planning to put up, is, well, we feel that there's a big endemic problem in the rest of Southeast Asia, and we think it's actually traffic. I mean, when I say traffic, like actual road traffic. How many of you guys have actually, I mean, I don't even want to do a hand raise, but what I mean by that is, hasn't it been obvious for a while that a lot of people have been complaining about traffic? And one of the solutions that we've been thinking of around that idea is, well, the opportunity for us to actually maximize the resources that we have in terms of understanding traffic. And that means maximizing roads, utilizing our vehicles completely, and maximizing the time that people spend on the roads. And what have we thought of actually doing is to create a safe, community-driven route-sharing platform which matches commuters and drivers both on the web and on mobile. So we have a mobile application on Android that's actually running for, well, in very, very private beta, and a web platform wherein people can log in. Well, let me show it to you right now. So, but first, before I actually do that, let me introduce you guys to the two players that are supposed to be on the system. On the left side, you've got Sam. On the right side, you've got Mike. Sam's our driver, and she's looking to share her ride with anybody. But she needs to access a network of people to do so. And on the other side, Mike's looking for a ride. Like, I'm a passenger, and I want to, at the same time, access a safe network of drivers. So, Sam accesses Stripit on her browser, and she signs in. And she signs in and adds a new route on the system. So she can define the start time, the price that she wants to identify for the ride, and the seats that are available, and so on and so forth. And then it shows up on the system. So Mike, on the other hand, has his mobile device and he's searching for a route and sees that Sam is sharing her route, and it so happens that Mike is traveling the same route as well, so he books it with his phone, and Mike searches for a route and sees that his friend, and they're on a trip. So Sam doesn't know Mike very well, but she sees that Mike has a positive overall rating on the system and approves his booking. So Sam and Mike meet up and the route start point, and they press start on their phone and they begin the trip. At the end of their trip, they press the end button and money is deposited into Sam's account and Mike is notified of the transaction. So Mike is pleased with Sam's performance and gives her a good rating. Similarly, Sam also enjoyed the ride with Mike and gives Mike a good rating. So when Sam and Mike reach your destinations, or when they press the end button, what we do is we generate a trip ticket that's accessible on social media. So we can share it on YouTube, Twitter, so on and so forth. And, well, just to give you an idea of why we're doing this, the Philippines generally is around, or at least Metro Manila is around, like 12 million people in a city. Allegedly, at least half is in the workforce, and the average Filipino spends 50 US cents per day moving in and out of the city. The truth is, there's actually a lot more because during the daytime, allegedly, Manila sprawls up to 15 million. So if we average that all out in a day, 50 cents times 5 days, it brings us to about $15 million in total market size. And what we want to do is we just want to take a small cut of that market. And in return, what we're doing is we're providing our market with a way to, well, match them on the social media spectrum, because we will be using, in part, also Facebook social graph, where you can match them if they like, I don't know, Lady Gaga. So Mike likes Lady Gaga, Sam likes Lady Gaga, we match them both on the same trip, and they can both listen to Lady Gaga on their way to trip. At the same time, we give them network, and on the opposite end, we also give them access to payment methods, which we've been doing work on, at least in the Philippines, mobile payment and internet payments. So, we're a relatively big team, actually. We're a team that comprises of designers and developers. We've been on this project for around 4 months now, and we're supposed to be doing a launch next week. So, on the other side of the spectrum, I've got my board, and they're a wonderful group of business developers and marketing guys, and I've got a finance guy and a lawyer on board as well, just to make sure everything's covered. But, you know what I mean, like, I think everybody's been liking booms so far, so I'm going to give you guys my last boom. And, you know what this number is? This is my boom. 56 trillion. Okay, so 56 trillion Indonesian rupiah. And that's the amount of money, allegedly, that the Jakarta Globe and the Philippine Daily Inquirer combined together say that both Manila and Indonesia are losing out on productivity dollars, because of lost time on the road or on traffic. And if you guys think that we can capture that 50 million slice that I talked about a while ago, what more if we become global? What more if we access that $6 billion productivity time for that one? So thank you very much in the name of our group, Mr. Pitt. And I hope we solve and disrupt traffic all throughout Manila and the rest of the region. Thank you.
Hi. We have similar kids from the previous batch of our institute. Exactly similar things, so it felt there's a need for that, but the idea was killed on the way. Because of a few issues, I want to see how you address that. One thing is this, it's about safety.
Right.
Because once they put it there, so they say they connect through Tripit, they go to the car together, then tomorrow the lady actually disappeared. And it's one bad story can actually kill the whole business. So that's one thing. Secondly, also is the system actually connect people, right? And you get paid whenever they use the system. But once they know each other, they pay one time, and the next day they say, "Wow, I just pay you directly." So that's the second issue. The third thing also is that there's a cheaper and already working solution called the TAPS.
I heard about that too.
Philippines, but there's a certain intersection. Well, it's actually people actually stop there. So they go with bus, they stop at that intersection, and they know who to meet because they've been there. So the car passed through and said, "Oh, I'm going to this area." Then who's coming? "Oh, I come with you. Then usually two or three people go there together because they think it's safer. But they go together and they actually come down together at the same place. So because of that, three main reasons that the idea was clear. How are we going to answer that?
Excellent.
Hello? Okay, excellent questions. We've actually been thinking about safety as the primary driver to ensure that our system moves forward and works. So, I don't know if you guys saw the app properly, but there was actually a panic button in there somewhere. okay, I didn't want to call it the panic button. It's actually called, what we call it is a community call. So basically what we're trying to do is we're trying to build a community-driven platform. And so what we're trying to do is we're trying to reward the community for helping other people who press that community call button, who help people address their concerns regarding the community. And that button is something that we feel is going to change us and allow us to also understand the behavior of the people that we will be working with. So that's one. You also talked about the transactional value of this project. Wherein you're trying to create continuous revenues. I think the problem, I'm not so sure how it works. We don't have a carpooling system in the Philippines. This is the first time I've actually seen it actually implemented in any country. But one of the things that we come to realize is that when you do that, you don't know where they're going, right? Our system actually tells you where these people are going. People are actually going to pay back. Do they find value in creating or knowing that this person is going on the same direction, right? And on top of that, what another part that makes it sticky is, well, what I didn't tell you was that the transactional model is just our local business strategy. But I haven't revealed actually what my global strategy is, because it might ruin, but I do have a plan. I'm telling you that I do have a plan, and it is part of that business model later on. But the most important thing is that we get people to actually use the system, even if we don't to match them on a network. And I feel that one of the things that I had to say was that why I feel that it can work is because not all routes are made equal, right? Like some routes are heavier, some routes are lighter, and nobody seems to understand that. So that's one way of looking at it. And finally, what was your last question again, sir? Sorry.
Recurring
payments. So they pay one time, but if they want the same person all the time, that's fine, right? I mean, we can get the part. The point is, we're trying to build the community and the engagement within the community. That's part of the business model too. If for example the driver, it's not every time that the driver is going to be passing that route all the time. What if they're a salesperson? What if they're sick? What if they need a ride? And at the same time, the passenger also needs a way to get to a location or to get to an endpoint, right? Regardless of whether or not he's using that same driver. So might as well use the system.
Yeah, I think Andy's questions were really good. Actually, I had a little bit of doubts, and after hearing this question, I had even more. I have a couple of questions myself. One is about, so you're using Android phones?
Currently, yes, but we are building a platform, so what I forgot to say was that I used to do a lot of mobile development back in Manila, so we're planning to also eventually move into BlackBerry and iOS devices. If you also considering that we're planning on scaling.
So if I understand your model is basically a carpooling service, you say you don't know any other carpooling service outside of, like, in other countries?
Oh no, I do. I mean, a lot of them. There are a lot of them, like in the US.
So it's kind
of I meant carpooling system, like the working one with a.
So it looks like it's kind of we could call it a car surfing carpooling. I feel that maybe there's a bit better business case trying to build some kind of Uber.
Okay, sorry.
So because this is more direct model, where basically I say I want to go from A to B, that might be maybe more suitable. I'm not quite sure. Because I feel that building the service you want to build requires a very, very important, like very large number of users. So it's very difficult to make it useful. The vision is great, like reducing traffic, and I like that. There's no problem about it. It's going to be useful only when there will be a lot of people. So that when I'm looking for somebody to help me go from where I am to where I want to go, there has to be someone. So basically getting there is going to be very difficult.
So actually, yeah, it goes back to the question of how do I build my user base, and part of that is actually first building the driver base. That's the most, I think the most critical ingredient is actually building the driver network. And yes, you're right about Uber. In fact, in a way, we are somewhat competing against Uber. From that perspective, Uber takes a 20%, but we're actually thinking just getting 10. But building the driver network in the Philippines, it's about partnering with the right. Okay. It's. I don't know how it is in Indonesia, but in the Philippines, we have what we call the Kolorong, which basically is a group of underground drivers who actually do some form of carpooling, but they're not legitimate servers. I don't even know if I should be saying this because it's recorded. But
we can wrap it up now. We're up to the 5 minutes. But thanks.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
We keep things moving along. Thank you, Trippin, everybody. Thank you.